At Tormach, we want to make your installation as easy as possible. So in this video, we're going to go over the installation of servos on your M machine to turn it into an M Plus machine. This video does not replace the Tormach technical document that came with your machine. Please read all of the warnings and cautions, tool requirements, and product information before you begin. Please note that certain items will be discarded or saved during this installation. Please save everything until the installation is complete. Before you begin to install the 1100M Plus Servo Upgrade Kit, you must verify that the PathPilot controller is updated to the most recent version of PathPilot. This is required as any version of PathPilot before version 2.2.0 do not include an M Plus configuration. To upgrade PathPilot, please click on the link above. At this point, if you have a lower serial number M-mil, then you may need to install the ECM 1.5 upgrade kit to replace the 1.4 board. Click on the link above. When you are done with that, return here to finish the installation. If you have any tooling in the spindle, remove it. Loosen the four screws securing the drip guard to the table with a 4mm hex wrench, then remove it and set it aside. Remove the tool tray with a 4mm hex wrench and set it aside as well. Remove the motor mount cover on both the X and the Y axis with a 3mm hex wrench and set them aside to be reused later. Identify the four set screws on both motor couplers and verify they are pointing towards you. If they are not accessible, jog the machine table until the set screws are pointing towards you. To prevent the spindle head from dropping onto the machine table, put a set of 2x4s on the machine table below the edge of the spindle nose. Slowly jog the Z-axis down until the spindle flange is set on the 2x4s. Please note, do not put the spindle nose on the set of 2x4s. If you do, it could add unnecessary force to the spindle bearings and cause damage to the machine components. Identify the Z-axis motor mount cover plate. Remove the motor cover from the machine column with a 3mm hex wrench. Set aside the screws and the motor cover. Identify the four set screws on the Z-axis motor coupler inside the Z-axis motor mount. To easily access the set screws, they must point towards the left side of the machine once the Z-axis is lowered. If the set screws are not pointing towards the left side of the machine, you can raise the Z-axis and flip the 2x4s, lowering the spindle down on top of it, and check to see if the couplers are accessible. Once the set screws are pointing towards the left, power off the machine and PathPilot controller. Push in the emergency stop button on the operator box. From the PathPilot interface, select exit. Turn the main disconnect switch to off. Remove the stepper motor drivers. Open the electrical cabinet door. Remove the wire trough covers. Remove the green connectors and the ribbon cable connectors from the X, Y, and Z stepper motor drivers. If you have a fourth axis motor controller, don't remove any wires from it. Remove the X, Y, and Z stepper motor drivers with a Phillips head screwdriver. Find the three ribbon cables that you removed earlier and then arrange them into the wire trough above the board. Disconnect all the wires from each connector with a small flathead screwdriver, discarding all three connectors. Identify the DC bus board. Remove wires 210, 211, 220, 221, 230 and 231 from the DC bus board. Remove all the stepper motor wires from the wire troughs. There are 15 in total. 210 through 214, 220 through 224, 230 through 234. Wires 210, 211, 220, 221, 230, and 231 are now completely disconnected from the electrical cabinet and can be discarded. Follow wires 400 and 435 from the Z-axis to their locations on the terminal block and the ECM board. Both are black. Remove wire 400 and wire 435 with a small flat-bladed screwdriver. Remove both wires from the wire trough. Remove the Z-column panel with a 3mm hex wrench. Set aside the screws and the column panel. Carefully move wires 212 through 214 222 through 224, 232 through 234, wire 400, and wire 435 out of the electrical cabinet and through the Z column opening. X-axis stepper motor removal. On the X-axis motor, loosen the two set screws on the coupler closest to the motor with a 3mm hex wrench. If you loosen all four set screws, the coupler could disconnect from the ball screw shaft. Follow the flex conduit to the machine column and remove it from the machine column with channel lock pliers. Pull the wires from the motor out of the machine column. Remove the plug next to the flex conduit fitting from the machine column with a flat blade screwdriver. Discard the plug. Remove the motor from the machine with a 4mm hex wrench. Remove the flex conduit from the X-axis motor. Set aside the mounting screws, washers, and flex conduit for the installation of the servo motors. Z-axis stepper motor removal. To relieve tension from the ball screw, first loosen the two set screws on the bottom of the coupler and retighten them. Then, to release the motor, loosen the top two set screws. Note, if you loosen all four set screws at the same time, the coupler could disconnect from the ball screw shaft. Remove the Z-axis flex conduit from the machine column with a pair of channel lock pliers. Pull the wire from the motor out of the machine column. Remove the motor from the machine with a 4mm hex wrench. Remove the flex conduit fittings from the machine column with the channel lock pliers. Discard the fittings. Y-axis stepper motor removal. On the Y-axis motor, loosen the two set screws on the coupler closest to the motor with a 3mm hex wrench. Note, if you loosen all four set screws, the coupler could disconnect from the ball screw shaft. Follow the flex conduit to the machine column and remove it. Pull the wires out of the machine column. If you have an early 1100M mill with a serial number from MA10266 and below, you only need to remove the right flex conduit fitting from the machine column. On mills with serial numbers from MA10267 and above, both the plug and the flex conduit fittings will need to be removed. Remove the motor from the machine with 4mm hex wrench. Set aside the mounting screws, washers, and flex conduit, then the motor and its wiring can be discarded if you want. X-axis servo motor installation. Find the X-axis servo motor, part number 38404, install it with the plug and oriented to the front of the mill. Then secure it using the screws and washers that you set aside earlier. Tighten the two set screws on the coupler closest to the motor with a 4mm hex wrench. Remove the six screws securing the plate to the motor cover with a 3mm hex wrench and set all aside. A template is provided in the documentation. Align it to the edge of the motor mount according to its label. Secure it temporarily with tape. Do this on both sides, holding the motor mount up to confirm the templates are positioned correctly. And finally, mark its location with a center punch. Remove the templates. Drill each hole with the drill provided. Each hole should be approximately 3/4 inch deep. Tap each hole that you drilled with the provided tap. Install the flex conduit fitting in place of the plug that you removed earlier. Reinstall the X-axis motor mount cover using the four screws provided and a 4mm hex wrench. You'll use two flex conduits to install the X-axis motor, one that you set aside earlier and one that you must assemble. Connect one end of both flex conduits to the motor cover. Find the servo power wires labeled 210 and 211 and the servo control wire labeled 424. Route the wires through each flex conduit fitting on the motor cover. Move the wire through the flex conduit fitting on the machine column and into the rear axis compartment. Tighten both flex conduits to their fittings on the machine column with channel lock pliers. Find the dielectric grease provided with the kit, then place some on the Molex connectors of the servo, power, and data wires. Connect the Molex connectors to the motor. Find the three plastic plugs provided in the kit and attach them to the motor cover. Add butyl tape around the top perimeter of the X-axis motor housing and underneath the tool tray screws. Install the X-axis motor mount cover. Press the tool tray into place and secure it with the original screws. If your tool tray sits proud of the machine table, squeeze it down with an F-clamp and then retighten the tool tray screws. Secure the motor cover plate with six screws that you set aside. Find the two wires that you put into the machine column in the rear axis compartment of the machine, then pull them into the electrical cabinet. Z-axis motor installation. Find two of the cable glands provided with the kit. Install the two cable glands. Install the Z-axis brake onto the machine column with the four washers, lock washers, and screws set aside before. Tighten the two set screws on the coupler closest to the motor with a 4mm hex wrench. Pull the Z-axis brake wires through one of the cable glands on the machine column. So that you can access it, align the Z-axis brakes coupler and the hole on the brake with a 4mm hex wrench. Leave it in place for alignment. Slide the Z-axis motor onto the coupler shaft and tighten the Z-axis brake coupler with the hex wrench. Then install it with the screws and washers provided in the kit. Find the servo power wires labeled 230 and 231 and the servo data wire labeled 426. Put one of the wires through each of the cable glands. Verify that the Molex connectors are on the servo side of the cable gland. Find the two Z-axis motor and brake wires and pull them into the electrical cabinet. Reinstall the Z-axis motor cover plate with the screws that you set aside earlier. Y-axis servo motor installation. Find the Y-axis servo motor and install it with the screws and washers that you set aside. Tighten the two set screws on the coupler closest to the motor with a 4mm hex wrench. Reinstall the Y-axis motor mount cover. If you have an 1100M mill with serial numbers from MA10266 and below, then find one cable gland and one cable cord grip and its corresponding nut. Install the cable gland in place of the Y-axis motor's flex conduit fitting. One of the servo cables will be routed into the electrical cabinet from one of the fittings above the ATC power input. Push out a fitting from inside and discard the plug. Secure the cable gland with its corresponding nut and then route the servo wire labeled 425 through the cable gland and into the electrical cabinet. And route the cable marked 210 and 211 into the gland and route it into the electrical cabinet. If you have an 1100M mill with serial number from MA10267 and above, then install two cable glands in the place of the Y-axis motor's flex conduit fitting and the plug next to it. Find the servo power wires labeled 220 and 221 and the servo data wire labeled 425. Put one wire through each of the cable glands. Find the two Y-axis servo wires that you put into the machine column and pull them into the electrical cabinet. Make electrical connections. Find the three servo control wires that you pulled into the electrical cabinet. Then find the three green connectors from the kit. Connect each control cable to one of the connectors as detailed in this table. Pin 1 can be identified by a small triangle on the outside edge of the green connectors provided in the kit. When installed, the connector will line up to pin 1 with a small arrow on the ECM board. Route the 424, 425, and 426 wires around the capacitor and up into the trough. Connect the data cables to the machine control board as detailed in the following table. Install the Z-axis brake wires 400 and 435 to their previous positions. Find the three servo power cables that you pulled into the electrical cabinet. Crimp one spade electrical connector to each of the wires with a wire crimper. Connect the power wires to the DC bus board as detailed in this table. From the DC bus board, route the wires into the wire troughs and towards the machine column. From the machine control board, route the wires into the wire trough and towards the machine column. Pull any excess wires into the machine column. Reinstall the wire trough covers. Close the electrical cabinet door. Verify the installation. Power on the machine and the PathPilot controller. After PathPilot restarts, confirm you have an M Plus configuration by looking next to the PathPilot logo. If not, type in admin config in the MDI line. Press Enter key and select the M Plus configuration. Then click Save and Exit. Bring the machine out of reset and reference the Z first. Remove the 2x4 from under the spindle. Then reference the X and the Y. Reinstall the drip tray. The 1100M Plus decals are included with this kit. The edge of the original decal can be lifted easily with just your thumbnail or very gently with a razor and then easily pulled back to remove. Clean the area with a degreaser to remove any oil or coolant. Give it a couple minutes to dry. Measure 7 inches from the bottom of the electrical cabinet and place a mark in several spots to help with alignment. Lightly spray the area with an ammonia-free window cleaner.
Then remove the protective backing from the decal and align the bottom with the marks. Once it's aligned, press on it and adjust it if necessary. Then push out all the air bubbles with a rag and then a plastic spatula, squeegee, or credit card. Give it a couple hours to dry and then come back and remove the transfer paper. Repeat these steps for the enclosure decal. Note, when removing the transfer tape for the decal, if the decal starts to come up, wait longer for it to dry. This concludes the installation of the 1100M Plus Servo Kit. If you have any troubles or need any assistance, please contact support@tormach.com. If you like what you saw, please go ahead and watch some of our other videos here and subscribe down here.